Well, dear students, today we shall learn about an adjective form and the degree of comparison. Okay, let me first of all tell you what is an adjective. Now, all of you must know it that you know adjective. It's a word which can qualify your noun. This is such a word which can qualify your noun. Now, for example, I have cited two examples for you. The first one, he is a bright student. Now student is a common noun and bright word, the word which I have circled, this is an adjective form. So this adjective is qualifying your noun, the student. So it's talking about your noun. It's something, you know, describing about your noun. So he is a smart boy. Look at the second example. He is a smart boy. Your boy is a common noun. Now this smart word, it is describing your noun, boy. Okay. So adjective means simply you understand the word which can qualify or which can describe your noun. Okay. Now let us study the different forms of your adjective. Like we have comparison of adjectives like positive, comparative and superlative. Okay, now we shall study the three different forms and we will categorize them into two. Let us study . Now we have a positive column. Now if I talk about comparison, okay. Now positive column we have, one is comparative, another one your superlative. Now three degrees you can find. One is your positive, another one is your comparative, next one is your superlative. Now in positive, suppose if I cite an example of bright, then it will become brighter and the superlative will become brightest. Like dark, darker, darkest. For example, if I just cite another example of beautiful, more beautiful and most beautiful. Now you see the changes. Sometimes see your comparative form, it is taking year and est in your superlative form. Okay, year and est. Now in some cases your comparative is not taking year, rather it is taking more, and your superlative will find most. Now I will be just telling you why it happens or how a child can be able to understand where the child can put year to make comparative and est to make superlative, either more or most to make comparative and superlative. Let us learn the very much very important lessons, you know, and it will be very much helpful. Some tricks that I will provide you how to know comparison and basically your superlative form and comparative form. Now, two
categories of adjective you will find. One is relatable, another one is unrelatable. Now two categories that I will just giving you. One your gradable adjective, another one ungradable. Clear? So gradable means it can take er in your comparative form and st in your superlative form. Clear? In comparative form, in all gradable adjectives you will find er and in superlative you will find st. Okay, now in ungradable adjective you will find more in your comparative form and most in your superlative. Clear? So wherever you can make your comparative form by using more, you can say it, you can name it as ungradable, and by using most, if you make your superlative form, then it can become also ungradable. But most of the adjectives which can be made their comparative and superlative by using er and est, so they are coming under gradable adjectives. So you may not know these terms, so please understand this and note it and know the different new terminologies. Now I will just start teaching you how you can, without any doubt, you can go with er in comparative and est, or more, or either any most also. Now let us study. Suppose when you are given any particular word which is consisting of only one syllable. Now the word having only one syllable can take er in comparative and st in superlative form. For example, bright. Okay. Or smart. These words, they are consisting of only one syllable. One syllable means, suppose a word can be consisting of more than one syllable. Okay. So we divide the word into different parts, you know, for our easy pronunciation. So bright word only, it is having only one syllable. Okay. So now this particular word, it can take er in comparative and est in superlative. For example, if I just cite one example. Handsome. Okay. Now this particular word, it is consisting of more than one syllable. Like we can pronounce like handsome, handsome. So two parts you can find, handsome. Okay. So like this, more than one syllable if you find in a word, then directly it can take er in, sorry, your more in comparative and most in superlative. Clear? Like beautiful, beauty, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Okay, more than one syllable there also you can find. So you can go with more and most in your superlative. So you please go on finding such words and you just read it out, try to pronounce the word. If you find more than one syllable, if you find more than one part which is there in the word, then please go with this more and most, and you try to understand this is coming under ungradable adjective. Okay, like a dart. Dart, it is consisting of only one single syllable, so it can become dark, darker, darkest. You can go with earliest one. Okay, like another example, sweet. This is again consisting of only one syllable, so you can go with ear and yes also. Sweet, sweeter, sweetest. Now if I just give you another example of your ungradable, and you see how more than one syllable is there. Like hard work. So you can divide them what you can divide. Hard working. Hard working. Okay. So more than one syllable you are noticing. So it can become more hard working, most hard working. Intelligent. You cannot place ER and EST in superlative and comparative form. By using ER, you cannot make comparative and superlative. So it will take rather your more and most in comparative and superlative. Hardworking, more than one syllable, so you can go with more and most, like your ungradable adjective. Okay, intelligent, intelligent, intelligent. More than one syllable you are noticing. So there also you can go with more and most. So dear students, I hope that the basic thing you have understood it, where to use ER and EST and where to use more and most. Is it clear? So I hope please understand who are the gradable adjectives and who are ungradable adjectives, and in ungradable category do not forget to use more and most in the comparative and superlative, and in gradable adjective blindly you can select ER in comparative, EST in superlative. So one syllable it will become gradable, more than one syllable it will become ungradable. Once it becomes gradable, then go with ER and EST, and when it becomes ungradable category, then please use more in comparative and most in superlative. So dear students, this is the basic thing that I am teaching you to improve your English grammar, you know. So please watch the video, like and subscribe, so that some new videos can be immediately uploaded in YouTube for you, and obviously it will enhance your vocabulary and other grammatical knowledge also. Okay, so till that time go with this, please revise at home and go with this particular lesson, watch the video. Thank you very much.